हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। यस, आई एम ऑडिबल। हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। प्लीज कंफर्म आई एम ऑडिबल। आई एम ऑडिबल टू ऑल। यस, ओके ओके, लेट्स बिगिन अवर टुडेज क्लास, टुडेज डिस्कशन। फ्रेंड्स, यू नो इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट रीहीटिंग, इंटरकूलिंग एंड यू कैन से रीजनरेशन। ओके, व्हाट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ दीज थ्री थिंग्स ऑन यू कैन से सिंपल ब्रेटन साइकिल। व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सिंपल ब्रेटन साइकिल? व्हेन वी से सिंपल ब्रेटन साइकिल, सिंपल ब्रेटन साइकिल मींस एयर स्टैंडर्ड ब्रेटन साइकिल। वी जनरली अज्यूम लाइक कंप्रेशन एंड एक्सपेंशन एज एन आइसेंट्रोपिक प्रोसेस एंड द हीट एडिशन इन यू कैन से कंबशन चैम्बर एंड हीट रिजेक्शन बोथ आर एट कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर एंड द वर्किंग मीडियम इज यू कैन से air. Okay, but in actual case, you know, the working medium is not air. Working medium is mixture of air and fuel. You know, only in compressor you are having air, but in combustion chamber, okay, and in all those, yes, Vicky, good morning. In all other things, like if you will see combustion chamber, if you will see turbine, there is air fuel mixture. Okay, so generally we assume, you know, what is the assumption for air standard cycle? All assumptions valid for this simple Brayton cycle also. Kinetic potential energy neglected because we are considering the change when we are finding out the work for a turbine or compressor. Only we are taking the change in enthalpy. That expression is valid only when we are neglecting kinetic energy and potential energy changes. Means we are assuming that the kinetic and potential energy at the inlet and exit of compressor, combustion chamber and a turbine, there is no change. Okay, these are our assumption. So we have discussed these three things related to simple Brayton cycle. What is simple Brayton cycle? What is the efficiency expression for simple Brayton cycle? What is optimum pressure? What is maximum pressure? And we discussed about reheating, regeneration and intercooling. What is the effect of these three on simple Brayton cycle? Okay, and what are the different expressions we have studied in today's class, friends? First we will discuss all questions which were asked related to this particular chapter, friends. Learning theory and applying, these two things are important. Like if you are studying some concept and you are not applying, then there is no use. In last class also I have selected 20 questions. You know, we have discussed 20 important engineering services question. There is nothing out of can be asked, you can say question can be asked like this only. Engineering question, if you will compare like from start of you can say 1996 to 2020, more than you can say 55 questions were asked related to this gas turbine chapter in engineering services. So I have only taken the 20 important question which I have discussed in you can say I discussed with you in last class, you know, at the end of the class. Today I have taken the important 15 question. Only 15 questions were asked from year 2001 to 2020 19. If you will compare total 15 questions we will discuss today. All are gate questions, gate previous year questions related to this particular chapter, guesstimate. So first try to discuss, and if any additional concept is required, like say we have not discussed about isentropic efficiencies, how to find out isentropic efficiencies, what is isentropic efficiency for turbine compressor, these things we have not discussed. So I will try to discuss these things if required with particular question. So let's move to our first question and try to solve it, friends. Okay, so let's move. This is our first question and asked in year 2019. A gas turbine with an air as a working fluid has an isentropic efficiency of 0.7. When operating at a pressure ratio of 3, the pressure ratio of the turbine is increased to 5. While maintaining the same inlet condition, assume air as a perfect gas with specific heat gamma equal to 1.4. If the specific work output remains the same for both the cases, the isentropic efficiencies for the turbine at the pressure ratio of 5 is. Try to solve this. This question was asked in year 2019. 2 marks. Ka. It is only related to, very easily you can solve this. Just apply basic concept. Okay, let me first discuss with you what is this isentropic efficiency. Okay, so what we, if I will ask you to draw the, you can say, simple Brayton cycle. So how you will draw simple Brayton cycle? So this is temperature axis, this is entropy axis, you know. Okay, first what you will draw? You will draw constant pressure line. Two constant pressure line you will draw. Then what you will draw? You will draw this isentropic compression and then this isentropic expansion. Okay, so cycle will be something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. What is one? One is the entry to the compressor. It is generally atmospheric pressure, atmospheric air. Atmospheric air is entering into the compressor. What is two? Two is the exit of the compressor and inlet of the combustion chamber. What is three? Three is the exit of the combustion chamber. Because in 2 to 3, we are adding heat. We are adding heat at constant pressure. Heat is supplied. Okay. So three is the exit of the combustion chamber or inlet of the turbine. What is four? Four is the exit of the turbine. 3 to 4, isentropic expansion takes place. 1 to 2, isentropic compression takes place. So this is ideal, you can say, air standards, air standard Brayton cycle. But in actual case, these processes are not isentropic. If you will draw actual cases, they may be, you can say, polytropic or something like that, but they are not isentropic. Okay. So in that case, we need to define the isentropic efficiency. If I will ask you, if they are not isentropic, then how these processes can occur? Where this 2 dash will lie? Where the exit of the compressor will lie? It will lie in the left of this or right of this. Okay. Generally, students are confused in this, where to locate this point 2, in the left of this or right of this. Okay. So I will tell you one thing. When I'm saying the process is not, you can say, isentropic, but process is adiabatic. Process is adiabatic, but it is not, you can say, isentropic. So means it is not reversible adiabatic, what you can say. So what we consider, like when the entropy change of, universe. But you can say entropy change of the universe is entropy change of the system plus entropy change of the surrounding. Okay. So entropy change of the surrounding is zero because we are considering the process is adiabatic, but process is not isentropic. So means there will be that some change in the entropy of the system. Entropy of the system will change. And what change we will observe? It will decrease or increase. Always it will increase. Why? Because entropy of the universe is always greater than equal to zero. It is equal to zero. Entropy change of the universe is equal to zero for reversible process. Okay, for remaining, what you can consider, like it will be greater than zero, means the entropy will increase. And when entropy will increase, so this 2 dash will point will lie here. This is the 2 dash. Okay, this point will lie here. And the curve will be something like this. Okay, this is the inlet to the compressor and this is the exit to the compressor. Okay, so this 2 dash, if I will ask you, this 2 T2 dash, this will be more than T2, yes or no? Because this is a constant pressure curve. So this T2 dash is greater than T2. Okay. So what it means? What it means, the actual work required by the compressor. Actual work. If I will ask you actual work of the compressor. Actual work which compressor requires. What is that? That is Cp. Specific work, if I will ask you. Specific work. Specific work means work per unit mass. So this is Cp into change in temperature, and change in temperature is T2 dash minus T1. Okay. So this T2 dash minus T1, this is more than T2 minus T1. Yes or no? Because T2 minus T1, that is less. T2 dash minus T1 is more. I think it is now clear. So this work, actual work required by the compressor is more than the isentropic work. If I will ask you, what is isentropic work? Isentropic work of the compressor is Cp into T2 minus T1. okay, and this is less than this. Getting a point? So that's why there one concept came, that is the isentropic efficiency. So if I will define isentropic efficiency of the compressor, isentropic efficiency of the compressor. So isentropic efficiency of compressor is W isentropic, okay, divided by W actual. Isentropic work required by the compressor divided by actual work required by the compressor. Okay, what is isentropic work? Isentropic work is this. Okay, what is actual work? This. So I can simply write this expression as, simply I can write this expression as T2 minus T1 divided by T2 dash minus T1. Okay, so this is the expression for isentropic efficiency of compressor. You can write in terms of change in enthalpy, and then you can put those temperatures. So this is the isentropic efficiency of the compressor. For reversible process, obviously this efficiency will be 1. Or 100%, you can say, because when the process is reversible, this isentropic efficiency will be 100%. Okay, but in other cases, he will give you this particular efficiency like this. In this case, the isentropic efficiencies of, you can say, yes, turbine is given. Because for turbine also, the process is node 3 to 4. The process will be something like this. Process will be something like this. Why I'm showing this 4 dash here? Why I'm showing 4 dash here? Because the entropy will increase. Entropy remains constant for a reversible process, but it will increase for other process. Okay, so when the process is not, you can say, isentropic, so entropy will increase, it cannot decrease. So this 4 dash will lie here. Okay, and what you can compare this in this T3 minus T4 dash, if I will compare for turbine, here I am writing this T3 minus T4 dash, it is less as compared to the, what you can say, T3 minus T4. Okay, so isentropic work, what you will get from the turbine, it is more. Isentropic work, what you will get from the turbine, it is more. But when it will not work isentropically, so the actual work, what you will get, that is less. Obviously, so there is one concept came for the isentropic efficiency of the turbine. So what is isentropic efficiency? Here I am writing isentropic efficiency of the turbine. Okay, so can you write this expression for turbine also? Yes, the isentropic efficiency for turbine is W actual by W isentropic. Okay, actual work produced by the turbine divided by isentropic work by the turbine. And this is, what is actual work produced by the turbine? Can I write it as a T3 minus T4 dash? Yes. And what is isentropic work? Isentropic work is again T3 minus T4. Okay, so this expression you can write for isentropic efficiency. Now you can easily solve this particular question. What is given? Both, in both the cases, like say in first case, suppose you will represent efficiency as efficiency 1. First case, efficiency is efficiency 1, because the compression ratio in first case, it is given the pressure ratio is 3. First case, pressure ratio is 3. And in second case, the pressure ratio is increased to 5. Pressure ratio increased to 5. But in both the cases, inlet conditions are same. Inlet condition same means T3 is same. Turbine inlet conditions are same in both the cases. So T3 is same. And you are getting same work output. For getting the same work output, what is the isentropic efficiency? Second case mein aapko isentropic efficiency kya mil rahi hai? When you have changed the, you can say, compression ratio, this pressure ratio you have changed. So what efficiency you are getting? So simply, you know, what is efficiency? Efficiency is the actual work divided by isentropic work. Why I'm writing actual here? Because this is the isentropic efficiency for turbine. Similarly, what is the, you can write here, if I will write WA will be efficiency 1 into W isentropic. Yes or no? Efficiency 1 into W isentropic equal to W actually same. In both the cases, you are producing same work, but efficiencies are different. Okay. So can I write efficiency 1 into W isentropic first case? Okay. Similarly, efficiency 2 into W isentropic in second case. Yes or no? Okay. So now if you will put all the values, you will able to get this. Okay, so what is efficiency 1 given? What is efficiency 1 given? The efficiency 1 is given, you can say 0.7. What is isentropic efficiency first case mein? What is isentropic efficiency in first case? So can I write, suppose this is 0.3, so can I write this as T3 minus, okay, or suppose T3, so P3 if I will take in common, and I can write it as a T3 divided by RP e power gamma minus 1. Yes or no? What is the exit temperature? What is exit temperature? This T4 in case of isentropy, because we want to write isentropic work. So what is exit temperature? This T4. Can I write this T4 Can I write this T4? Because what is T3 by T4? T3 by T4 is Rp ki power gamma minus 1. Yes. T3 by T4 is a pressure ratio ki power gamma minus 1. So what is T4? T4 is a T3 by Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Yes or no? Yes or no? This. So if you will put this value here, what is T4? T4 is T3 by this. And simply if I will take T3 common. Simply if I will take T3 common. So what you can write inside? 1 minus 1 by Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Yes. This expression you can write. Okay. Similarly, this you want to find out. Efficiency for second case. You want to find out. Efficiency for second case you want to find. And similarly, can I write this isentropic work in second case? So can I write this as a T3? Suppose here RP is RP1 because pressure ratios are different. In this case, the pressure ratio is given 3. I think yes. First case pressure ratio is 3. Second case pressure ratio is 5. Okay, so I can write it as 1 minus RP2 the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Yes or no? So everything is given to you. Simply you can compare because this T3 will cancel out. There is no need of T3. There is no need of T3. T3 will be cancelled out because inlet conditions are same for both the cases. So simply in this expression, if you will put RP1, 3, RP2, 5. Because initial case RP1 is 3, second case RP2 is 5. So if you will compare this, you will get efficiency 2. Yes or no? Okay, I will answer. Yes. Sahu, I will answer your question. First, let's complete this particular question, then I will ask you. Then, okay, so I will discuss that question. So the efficiency 1 is 0.7 into this T3 will be cancelled out. Okay, so simply RP1 you will put 3, RP2 you will put 5. Just tell me what answer you are getting. Just tell me what efficiency 2 you are getting. Yes. What efficiency 2 you are getting. This is for year 2019 question. Very easy concept. Related to isentropic efficiency, just tell me what answer you are getting. Yes, efficiency 2. Anybody? Anybody found the answer? Yes. And you need to round off your answer up to 2 decimal places. Okay. Try to calculate what answer you are getting. Yes, if I will write answer for you, that will come out 0.5116. Here I am writing, the answer will come out 0.5116. Okay, and you can round off it to 2 decimal places. So you can write it as 0.51, it will be right. So 0.5116, that is the efficiency 2. In second case, you will get. I think it is now clear. Yes, all. Yes, good. Good, Sahu, good. You're 51%, yes. You can approximate it to 51% or 0.516. Good, Sahu. Yes, 0.51. Okay. Yes. Okay. So Sahu is asking why we cannot use ideal gas equation in superheated region. Suppose if we will talk about the gas power cycle. Okay. In gas power cycle, we can apply because the gas is there everywhere. Okay. We can apply, yes, superheated equation because air which is present. If I will say the air which is present in our room, in which condition it is? It is in superheated condition. Okay. So you can apply ideal gas equation easily. But if I will say ki vapor power cycle, okay, in vapor power cycle, you know, if there is some vapor, okay, so you cannot, for vapor, you cannot apply this ideal gas equation. But if it is at very high temperature, then we can approximate, we can apply, we can consider it to like ideal gas equation. But what is the meaning of ideal gas? Ideal gas means the gas in which the intermolecular force of attraction is negligible and the particles are very far away. Okay. And what you can say, the mean free path is this much of large. It is larger than the, you can say it is reach approaching the, you can say dimension of the container. These are some assumptions. And the point mass, the mass of the particle of gas is, you can say it is a pointed mass and there is a negligible force of attraction. So that we will get in case of air. Even for air, we can apply for at low pressure, this normal temperature and conditions, which we generally observe in our mechanical equipments. So we can apply ideal gas equation for this particular air also. The air, which we get like mixture of nitrogen, oxygen and water vapor. But in actual case, if I will say the air at high, very high pressure, then also you cannot apply ideal gas equation for air also. Getting a point? So that depends which type of fluid you are using. It is a vapor power cycle. It is an air standard cycle. When we are saying air standard cycle, in this case, these are air standard cycle. The working medium is air only. So you can apply, we are applying this expression. When we are writing the change in enthalpy as Cp T1, this expression for what? This is the expression for ideal gas only. Because for ideal gas, we can write the change in enthalpy as Cp dT. Okay, but if there is some vapor mix, we cannot write this as Cp T1. We need to use steam table. Okay, so if there is some vapor mix, I think that's how this is clear to you. Yes, Sahu, I think your question is clear, right? So let's move to second question. This is comparatively easy one. This is from year 2017. Year 2017 question. We will discuss every question related up to 2000, from 2019 to 20 in reverse manner, because you know weightage will be more related to, you can say, we can expect like the question which were asked in latest examination like 2019 or 18. In 2000, close to 2000, question were asked of, you can say, 5 marks. Okay, and they are very much lengthy. So first, try to solve this question. This is from year 2017. Same question, we have discussed every concept related to this. You will be easily able to answer. Okay, the pressure ratio across a gas turbine for specific heat. Okay, the pressure ratio across a gas turbine for air specific heat at constant pressure, Cp equal to this. This is in joule. This is in joule per kg Kelvin. And the specific heat gamma equal to 1.4 is 10. The pressure ratio is given to you. If the inlet temperature to the turbine is this and the isentropic efficiency is this, so can you find out the exit temperature? Very easy question, friends. In earlier question, we have discussed the concept related to isentropic efficiency. Okay, only if you will go through that 5 minutes it will take, if you are coming this time. So that concept, if you know, easily you can solve. Okay, very easy question, friends, from year 2017. Try to solve first, then I will discuss with you. Try to solve it, then I will discuss it with you. Okay, the pressure ratio across a gas turbine, easily you can solve. Okay, let me give you a hint. If you want, let me give you a hint. Suppose those know that particular concept, they can try to solve. For others, because time is important, you know, I am giving the concept again. So this is temperature, this is entropy. And where the expansion takes place? The expansion takes place from 3 to 4 in turbine. This is the isentropic expansion. But actual process is not like this. That process may be like this only. Okay, so this is 3 entry to the turbine. This is for isentropic. When the turbine efficiency is 100%, means isentropic efficiency is 100%. Isentropic efficiency means the expansion is taking place reversible adiabatic. If the expansion taking place reversible adiabatic, then the process will be isentropic. Then you will get 4 here. But if it is not reversible adiabatic, it is not isentropic, the 4 will be here. Okay. And you know, what is isentropic efficiency? Isentropic efficiency of turbine. What is the isentropic efficiency of the turbine? Okay, so if you will face difficulty in how to remember this, just learn one thing. In case of compressor, when work supplied will be less, when it will work reversibly, yes or no? And when you will get work in turbine more, when it will be work reversibly, yes or no? So always this efficiency will be less than one. Yes or no? This will be less than one. So how to get that ratio? Simply. So if you know the work which you will get, that is more in isentropic. So here write first W isentropic. Yes or no? Then you will not face any difficulty in writing. You will not be confused. Simply, you know, efficiency will be less than one. And you know, the isentropic work done by the turbine will be more when it will work reversibly. Okay. So this value is more and this is less. You can write, but for compressor, it will be reversed. Why? Because the isentropic work supplied, because in case of compressor, we are supplying work. So isentropic work supplied will be less and the actual work supplied will be more. So in that case of compressor, what we will write? We will write W isentropic work given to the compressor divided by actual work given to the compressor. And the actual work given to the compressor will be more as compared to the isentropic work. In that manner, you will not even... you can say it will. You will able to remember this for a long period of time. Okay. So this, if you will mention here, what is actual work? Actual work is, you can say T3 minus T4 dash. What is this isentropic work? This is T3 minus T4. Okay. So everything is given to you. If you will put all values, what is T3? T3 T3 is given. Inlet temperature to the turbine is 1200 Kelvin. So this is 1200 Kelvin. Okay. This you want to find out. Exit temperature you want to find out. This T4 dash you want to find out. Okay. Here, can I write this as T3? Okay, same like this earlier case. Can I write this as 1200 into 1 minus 1200 by Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma? Yes or no? Yes. What is T4? T4 is T3 by Rp ki power gamma minus 1. So, okay, here I have taken the already taken the this common. So, 1200 I have already taken the common. So, this will be 1200 into 1 minus 1 by Rp ki power gamma minus 1. Yes or no? Or you can multiply it inside. So, T3 minus T3 by Rp ki power gamma minus 1. So, simply everything is given to you. In this question, everything is given to you. Simply, if you will put this temperature, Rp is given to you. Yes, Rp is 10. The pressure ratio given is 10. Okay, so if you will put this pressure ratio, gamma is also given to you, 1.4. You will get this temperature T4 dash. Just tell me what value you are getting. Yes, this is asked in this particular question. What is the exit temperature? Just tell me what value you are getting. Exit temperature. Okay, thank you, Sahu. Thank you. बिल्कुल करेंगे. देखो फर्स्ट वी नीड टू कंप्लीट दीस पर्टिकुलर थिंग्स. गैस टर्बाइन क्वेश्चन यू विल एबल टू आंसर एवरी क्वेश्चन इफ यू विल गो टू दीस थ्री क्लासेस लाइक फर्स्ट वन सेकंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन यस्टरडे क्लास. दिस वी आर कंप्लीटिंग दिस. सो दिस इज पर्टिकुलर यू कैन से सीक्वेंस लाइक फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस थ्योरी देन वी विल गो फॉर कंसेप्ट. इन टुडे आल्सो आई विल डिस्कस सम कंसेप्ट रिलेटेड टू स्टीम टर्बाइन एंड देन इन नेक्स्ट टू क्लासेस वी विल कंप्लीट दैट पर्टिकुलर स्टीम टर्बाइन क्वेश्चंस. ओके एंड देन वी विल सॉल्व क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू दिस. इफ यू विल गो टू एनी एग्जाम लाइक गेट और एनी अदर यू विल फाइंड क्वेश्चंस आर मोस्टली आज रिलेटेड टू स्टीम टर्बाइन पावर प्लांट एंड गैस टर्बाइन पावर प्लांट ओनली. न्यूक्लियर और एनी अदर पावर प्लांट जियोथर्मल और हाइड्रो दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट ऑल्सो रिलेटेड टू लाइक वेलोसिटी और टर्बाइन क्वेश्चन दिस यू विल कवर इन मशीनरी पार्ट. Okay, so in this power plant chapter, you know, the thermal power plant and you can say this gas turbine power plant are very important. Nuclear extra, the theoretical question can be asked related to this, but there is no numerical will be asked related to nuclear power plant or geothermal power plant or solar power plant. You will not find any question related to these type of power plant in GATE. Okay, so try to answer what question, what answer you are getting? Yes. Just tell me T2, T4 dash, what answer you are getting? No, nobody has answered. So T4 dash will come out 679. T4 dash will come out 679.38. This will come out 679.38. Clearly mentioned, you need to find this temperature in Kelvin. So everybody is getting this answer. 679.38. This is the exit temperature. If you will put this compression pressure ratio 10, gamma 1.4, gamma is given. Okay, because all it is. If it is not given, you some CPCV value will be given, and if CPCV value will be not be given, it will be mentioned. Like consider air standard Brayton cycle. So you will consider gamma as 1.4 only. So yes, everybody is I think getting that answer. Yes. Rohit is saying 680 close. Yes, it is close to 680. 679.38 is close. Yes, good, Rohit. Let's move to next question. Yes. Okay. This is from year 2016. Consider a simple gas turbine Brayton cycle with perfect regeneration. Very good question, friends. Perfect regeneration, he is saying. In both cycles, the pressure ratio is 6. And the ratio of the specific heat is 1.4. Gamma is 1.4. Pressure ratio is both the cases is 6. The ratio of minimum to maximum is 0.3 in the regenerative cycle. The ratio of the thermal efficiency of the simple Brayton cycle and simple regenerative cycle. Very good question, friends. Normal question you can ask you can say solve. This is also easy, very easy. If you know the expression of efficiencies for, you can say, simple Brayton and regenerative cycle. If you know the expression, easily you can find out the ratio. So in this question, if you will find out, let me give you a hint. Okay. So what is efficiency of the simple Brayton? What is the efficiency of simple Brayton? The efficiency of simple Brayton is 1 minus 1 by Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Yes or no? This is the efficiency of simple Brayton. Okay. Efficiency of simple Brayton. Okay, and you can write it as 1 minus 1 by C also. I told you, This is 1 minus 1 by C, efficiency of simple written. Okay, what is C? C is the T2 minus T2 by T1. What is C2? What is C? C is the temperature, you can say ratio of the compressor, means exit temperature of the compressor, inlet temperature of the compressor. T2 by T1, this is the exit temperature, this is the inlet temperature. And you know what is T2 by T1? It is nothing but it is P2 by P1, T power gamma minus 1 by gamma, yes or no? And what is P2 by P1? It is nothing but it is RP, pressure ratio. So pressure ratio ki power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Okay. So this is the expression. Sometime if you will find this type of expression, and it is mentioned ki C is this. So this is also the expression for simple Brayton efficiency. Okay. Similarly, if I will ask you, what is the efficiency of a regenerative cycle? What is the efficiency of regenerative cycle? It is 1 minus, you can say C by T, or let me write this first, this T 1 minus T minimum by T maximum. T minimum by T maximum into RP power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Okay, so this is the expression for efficiency of regenerative cycle. This is the expression for efficiency of simple Brayton cycle. This is the efficiency for expression of efficiency for regenerative cycle. What is the meaning of regenerative? When you are using a heat exchanger, okay, you are recovering heat, you are utilizing waste heat. Okay, that is known as a regenerative cycle. So in this case, how you can write efficiency? You can write efficiency like this also. 1 minus C by T. What is C? C is again this term. This term is C, you know. 1 minus C by T. What is T? T is T max by T minimum. T is the temperature limit. T max by T minimum. So you can remember formula from like this. 1 minus C by T or like this. Okay. So everything is given to you. If you will put all values, you will get answer. Both the cases, pressure ratio is 6. Okay. So you need to find, suppose this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. Okay. So if you will divide 1 by 2, what you will get? You will get expression for efficiency of simple Brayton by efficiency of regenerative cycle. Okay. In this case, what expression you are getting? 1 minus 1 by RP power gamma minus 1 by gamma. In this expression, what you are having? You are having 1 minus T minimum by T maximum into RP power gamma minus 1 by gamma. This ratio, he asked you to find out this ratio of the efficiency of simple Brayton and regenerative cycle. So RP is 6 for both the cases. Gamma is 1.4. So you can easily solve this numerator part. For denominator part, T minimum, T maximum, both are given. This ratio is given to you. T minimum by T maximum. The ratio of minimum temperature to maximum temperature is 0.3. Okay, so if you will put all values, this value, you will put 0.3. This value is given to you, the ratio of T minimum to the T maximum. It is 0.3 given to you. RP is given to you, 6. Gamma is 1.4. You will easily get this ratio. Just tell me what ratio you are getting. Yes, try to solve this. What ratio you are getting? So if you will solve this, you will get this. Because you know we are having limited time, hai na? So I want to cover all questions and some theory part also. That's why I'm not allowing you to solve, hai na? So this ratio will come out, efficiency of simple Brayton by efficiency of regenerative cycle. That will come out to 0.8013. Okay, so this will come out 0.8031. I think some of you are getting this particular answer. Yes. Okay, let's move to next question. Okay, so this is our question number four. This you can easily answer. ये तो इसमें तो time लगना ही नहीं चाहिए. ये तो सभी answer कर सकते हैं. Yes, very easy. Within second you can answer this question. Asked in year 2015. ये तो एक second का question भी नहीं है. Within 1 second you can answer. What is this cycle? अब इसको Brayton मत बोल देना. This is not a Brayton cycle because this is not clockwise. What I told you? ऑल क्लॉकवाइज साइकल्स आर पावर प्रोड्यूसिंग साइकिल. तो अगर आपको ब्रैटन दिख जाए तो ब्रैटन मत आंसर कर देना, हालांकि इसमें कोई ब्रैटन दिखा नहीं है, इसमें सिर्फ रिवर्स ब्रैटन है. बट अगर पहला ऑप्शन ही ब्रैटन आ जाए तो बच्चे ब्रैटन ही आंसर कर देंगे. इट इज नॉट ब्रैटन, इट इज रिवर्स ब्रैटन. दिस इज पर्टिकुलर साइकिल विच इज यूज इन एयर रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टम. रिवर्स ब्रैटन साइकिल वी यूज इन एयर रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टम. ओके, सो आंसर क्या हो जाएगा इसका, ऑप्शन बी एयर. व्हाई इट इज एयर रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टम, बिकॉज इट इज एंटी क्लॉकवाइज. All anti-clockwise cycles are power absorbing cycle. Got any point? So simply you can answer option B. Yes, Rohit, good. Let's move to next question. This is question number next, 5. Again, it is again theoretical question asked in year 2014. Theoretical question asked in year 2014. Very easily you can answer. For a gas turbine power plant, identify the correct pair of statement. Correct pair of statement, just select. So what answer you are getting, just tell me. Compare every statement and answer what answer you are getting. Okay. So if you will compare like weight to power ratio, what do you know about weight to power ratio? We have mentioned the weight to power ratio. When we have compared this particular steam power plant and gas turbine power plant, I mentioned there. The weight to power ratio for steam power plant is higher as compared to the weight to power ratio for the gas turbine power plant. The weight to power ratio, generally, if you will compare a steam power plant, it is in the range of 55 kg per kilowatt. Okay, that is the weight to power ratio for steam turbine power plant. For gas turbine power plant, it is slightly lower. It is close to 20 kg per kilowatt. Okay, so what you are getting? 20 kg weight is required, 20 kg of the plant weight for per kilowatt power production. But in steam power plant, 55 kg of the weight of the plant per kilowatt of power production. So what you are getting from this? The weight to power ratio for gas turbine power plant is less. So the for gas turbine power plant, identify the correct pair. So is this is right, smaller in size compared to steam power plant? Yes, if the weight to power ratio of the particular gas turbine power plant is less, so yes, it will be smaller. So this term is right. This is right. Starts quickly compared to steam power plant. Yes, that is the advantage. That's why we use gas turbine power plant for meeting the peak load demand. Generally, if you will go to any power generation unit, you will find combined system like this type of gas turbine system and steam turbine system. One question was asked in engineering services also. What is the name of that system? That is the name is combined cycle. Combined cycle means a cycle which is a combination of, you can say, steam power plant and gas turbine power plant. And we use this type of system. Why? Because the demand is uncertain. The electricity demand is not in your hand. You can predict up to some amount. You can predict what will be the demand in that particular day. You can predict, but it may increase, it may decrease anytime. Okay. So if there are sharp fluctuations, so if there is a fluctuation of energy, that you cannot meet by a steam power plant. Steam power plant are used for meeting the base load demand. Base load demand means the demand which is almost continuous, you can say almost constant throughout the year. That is base load demand. So steam power plant are used to meet the base load demand. But if there is a fluctuation of energy, the fluctuation of demand, that is meted by gas turbine power plant. So easily we can start. Suppose if there is a demand is high, so you will turn on gas turbine power plant very quickly. And if that demand is not there, you can shut down that plant. But for steam turbine power plant, it will take a very large time for starting and shutting down. Okay. So this is also right. But this is work on the principle of Rankine cycle. No. Gas turbine power plant works on Brayton cycle, or what you can say, Joule cycle. But this works on the Rankine cycle. Steam turbine power plant works on Rankine cycle. The standard cycle for steam turbine power plant is Rankine cycle. Good quality of solid fuel? No. There is no solid fuel is used. Solid fuel are used in steam turbine power plant, coal. We can, because these are closed cycle system. Closed cycle, you can use any fuel. So solid fuel we use in steam turbine power plant. So only P and Q are right. So option A is right. Option A is right. Let's move to next question. I think this is our, yes. Next question number 6, I think. Try to answer this. An ideal Brayton cycle, atmospheric air, Cp by Cv is 1.4. Specific heated constant pressure is given at 1 bar and 300 Kelvin is compressed to 8 bar. The maximum temperature in the cycle is limited to 1280 Kelvin. The heat supplied rate is 80 megawatt. The mass flow rate of the air required in this cycle. What is the mass rate of the air required in this cycle? Try to solve this very easy question. Very easy. If you will draw the cycle diagram, easily you will be able to answer. First, any question will be asked related to this. First, draw cycle diagram. ES diagram. It is easy to draw. Right? Draw constant pressure line. Okay. This is point one. Suppose compression. Okay. This is heat addition. And this is, you can say, expansion. And this is heat rejection. So, this is heat addition process, you know. This is heat addition process. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. This is heat rejection. Heat rejection. This is compression, isentropic compression in compressor, isentropic expansion in turbine. So heat addition is given to you. It is given 80 megawatt. And he asks you the flow of the air. Because work is, heat supply is not given in kilojoule or megawatt per kg. It is given in megawatt. Okay. So it is not the specific heat input. It is the total heat input, 80 megawatt. Okay. So if you will compare this, if you will write simple basic thermodynamic knowledge by using that concept, you can solve. So what is heat addition? What is heat addition? Heat addition is m dot mass flow rate into Cp into change in temperature. What is the change in temperature? Change in temperature is the T3 minus T2. Yes. M dot Cp T3 minus T2. This is the change in temperature we are getting in heat addition. And where heat addition is taking place? Heat addition is taking place from 2 to 3. So if you will put all values, this is given to you, 80 megawatt. Suppose I am writing this in kilowatt. I am writing this in kilowatt because the Cp I will put in kilojoules. So this I will put in kilojoule, 1.005. Because this is in kilojoule, this is in kilowatt. Okay, so both are of same unit. Into T3, what is T3? T3 is the maximum temperature. What is maximum temperature given? It is 1280. What is T2? How to find out T2? T1 is given to you. This T1 is given to you. Can you find out T2? Easily you can find out. So T2 will be T1 times RP power. RP power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So T2 will be T1 times here. Because in this case, this is the high temperature. T2 by T1 is T2 by P1 ki power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So T2 equal to T1 times RP ki power gamma minus 1 gamma. What is RP? What is the exit pressure? Exit pressure is 8 bar. This exit pressure is 8 bar. What is inlet pressure? It is 1 bar. Exit pressure is 8 bar. Inlet pressure is 1 bar. So what is the ratio? What is the pressure ratio? It is 8 only. It is 8 only. So if you will put all gamma, if you will put 1.4, or you can directly write it as, I think it will come out 2/7. You can write it as like this. 2/7. So T2 equal to T1 into RP ki power gamma minus 1 by gamma equal to 8 into 2/7. So you will get a T2 from this. You will get a T2 from this. Okay. So if you will put value of T2 here, easily you will get this mass flow rate. Easily you will get this mass flow rate. Just tell me what answer you are getting. Yes, Rohit, anybody getting this answer? Anybody getting answer? If you will solve for T2, you will get a T2 in the range of 543.43. You will get this T2. Just check it out. You will get a 543.43 Kelvin. This T2 you will get. Just tell me what is the mass flow rate you are getting. Rohit, some mistake in calculation. Check it again. I think there is some mistake in calculation. Just check it again. I think it will come out 108.071 kg per second. Rohit, again check your calculation. It will come out in this range. I think you have done some mistake. T2 will be come out 543.343. Check it again. If you are again getting this answer, yes. Yavar Farooq is getting right answer. Good Farooq. 108.071. This is the right answer. Yavar, good. Yes, Kameshwari. Kameshwari is also getting right answer. 108.07. Yes, this is right. Okay. So let's move to next question. Can I move? Okay. I think all have solved this particular question. Let's move to next question. Question number 7. This is easy one. I think this will not take second. What is the thermal efficiency of a standard air standard Brayton cycle? As in year 2014, easily, I think there is no need of discussing. Yes. Option D kya ho jayega, hamara right answer ho jayega. Because kya hoti hai? Here I am writing, efficiency of simple Brayton is 1 minus 1 by RP. power gamma minus 1 by gamma. What is efficiency of a regenerative cycle? Regenerative, it is 1 minus 1 t minimum by t maximum into rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Okay, so in this case he asked you the efficiency of simple air standard Brayton cycle. So option D kya ho jayega hamara, it will be right. Option D kya ho jayega hamara, it will be right. Okay, let's move to next question. Question number 9, 8, I think. So this is a linked answer question. This one, this is good one comparatively. This is good one. Try to solve. Very easy. Just go by basic knowledge, basic concept. Just draw a cycle and try to solve. You will easily able to solve it. Okay. This is linked answer question asked in year 2013. 4 marks question. Normally power plant 4 marks are very scoring, right? So you can easily solve. Just try to solve. Two questions are there. Linked answer question. So let me discuss that basic concept. What is required for that particular question? In a simple Brayton cycle, the pressure ratio is 8. So pressure ratio is given to you. And it is given, it is a simple Brayton cycle. So then first draw the simple Brayton cycle. Okay. So what is simple Brayton cycle? The simple Brayton cycle will be something like this. Yes or no? It will be something like this. This is point 1. This is point 2. This is point 3. This is point 4. And this like this. So this is simple Brayton cycle. So what is next given? The pressure ratio, this. Suppose the P2, this is P1, and what is given? The P2 by P1 is 8. This is also given to you. The pressure ratio is 8. Okay, remaining the entrance to the compressor and turbine are 1400 Kelvin. So the entry to the temperature is, entry to the compressor is 300 Kelvin. Means this T1, here I am writing, T1 is 300 Kelvin. What is exit to the, what is entry to the turbine? Entry to the turbine is T3. So T3 is 1400 Kelvin. This is also given to you. Both compressor and gas turbine have isentropic efficiency equal to 80%. Means the process is simple, but it is, they are having some isentropic efficiency. Means actual cycle will be something like this. Okay, because isentropic efficiencies are given. So this is 0.2 dash, this is 0.4 dash. This is 0.2 dash, this is 0.4 dash. Okay, so isentropic efficiencies are given, and isentropic efficiencies for both compressor and turbine is 80%, means 0.8. This is given to you. Okay, for the gas, assume a constant value of Cp equal to 1 kilojoule. Ab isko 1 hi use karna hai. When he has mentioned ki use Cp value 1 kilojoule, so use Cp 1 kilojoule only. And ratio of the specific heat is 1.4. Ratio of the specific heat is 1.4, means gamma is 1.4. Neglecting change in kinetic energy and potential energy, the power required by the compressor. This is comparatively easy, but in this case, some student can do some mistake. I will discuss what is that mistake you will do generally. So the power required by the compressor in kilowatt. What is the power required by the compressor in kilowatt? Okay, so how you will find out power required by the compressor? So what is isentropic efficiency of the compressor? Isentropic efficiency of the compressor is W, you can say isentropic by W actual. The isentropic efficiency of the compressor is W actual by W isentropic by W actual. Okay. So what you need to find out? You want to find out W actual, power required by the compressor. Okay. It is having some isentropic efficiency. So what is the actual power? What is the actual work required by the particular compressor? Okay. So can you find out? And he asked this in kilowatt per kg. Specific power. Specific power means kilowatt per kg. So there is no need of taking mass. So simply what you can write this? You can write a W isentropic divided by isentropic efficiency of the compressor. So this W actual you want to find out. So if you will put this isentropic, what is isentropic? It is Cp into T2 minus T1, because this is isentropic work. Isentropic work is Cp T2 minus T1 divided by, what is isentropic efficiency of the compressor given? The isentropic efficiency of the compressor given is 0.8. Isentropic efficiency of the compressor given is 0.8. Okay. So from this easily you can find out this. You can easily find out this W actual, because Cp is given to you 1 kilojoule and you want to find out work in kilowatt per kg. So this you need to put in kilojoule only. Kilojoule. Kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Okay. So this is given 1 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. T2. How you can find out T2? This pressure ratio is given to you. So T2 kya ho jayega hamara? Here I am writing. T2 will be T1 times RP power gamma minus 1 by gamma. RP is given to you 8. T1 is given to you 300 Kelvin. Easily you can find out T2 from this. So if you will put T2 here, T1 here, CP here, you will get the work required by the compressor. Yes, anybody getting answer? You can easily find out the work required by the compressor. Yes, try to solve. Yes, Sanjay, good. Good, Sanjay. Yes, anybody getting answer? What will be the power required by the compressor? So if you will solve this, you will get answer close to 304. This you will get. Because you know, this answer you will get 304.3. Anybody getting this answer? Yes, good. Kameshwari P. Yes, good. Good. So this is 304.3. Okay, just solve this also. This is also linked answer question. The thermal efficiency of the cycle is in percentage. He asked you the thermal efficiency. Thermal efficiency. So अभी इसमें बच्चे mistake क्या करेंगे देखो. जो कुछ करो ना तो उससे पहले मैं आपको बता दूँ. What mistake generally student do in this? So they will apply the simple formula 1 - 1/Rp की power gamma minus 1. Because Rp is given to you. If you will apply that formula, you will get wrong answer. You will even get I think close to 44 or something like that. You can check. But that is wrong. Why? It is for that when the isentropic efficiencies are high, even say 100%. The process is isentropic compression, isentropic expansion. So ideal Brayton cycle, you can apply for that. 1 - 1/Rp ki power gamma minus 1. So in this case, you need not to apply that formula. What do you need to do? You need to find out isentropic thermal efficiency. So thermal efficiency, what will be the thermal efficiency? It is the W net. What you will do? W net by heat supplied. W net by heat supplied. So you need to calculate this because this is a linked answer question. If you will apply, generally student do that particular, you can say they will try to solve question by that particular short trick, you know, 1 - 1/Rp power gamma minus 1, but that answer will be wrong because you need to find out the actual efficiency. What is that? That is W net by QS. What is W net? What is W net? W net is WT, W turbine minus W compressor. By heat supplied. Okay, here I am writing. What is WT? Can I write this as CP into T3 minus T4? T3 minus T4 minus T2 dash plus T1. Yes, is this expression you will get for W net? What is W net? W net is here also. You need to apply T4 dash. T3 minus T4 dash. Okay. T3 minus T4 dash, because this is the W net. What is W net? W net is turbine work minus compressor work. What is the turbine work? It is CP T3 minus T4 dash, not T3 minus T4. So it is T3 minus T4 dash. What is compressor work? It is CP T2 dash minus T1. So CP I have taken common. So what you will get? T2 dash plus, because minus sign, if you will take inside, it will become T2 dash plus T1. This is the actual net work. Divided by what is heat supplied? What is heat supplied? Heat supplied is CP T3 minus T2 dash. Here also you need to use T2 dash. Here also you need to use T2 dash. Okay. Here also if you, yes. Here also you need to put, yes. W, yes. This is the, why I have written T2 here? Because this is not the actual work. This is the isentropic work. This is the isentropic. How to get this T2 dash? Easily. If you will compare this, here I'm writing, if you will compare W actual, what is actual work required by the compressor? The actual work required by the compressor is CP into T2 dash minus T1. This is the actual work required by the compressor. And you have calculated this work. You have already calculated this work. This is T304.3. So from this expression, you can find out T2 dash. From this expression, you can find out T2 dash. Similarly, when you find out the actual work of the turbine, you will be able to find out T4 dash also. It will take some time. Because it is not a 2 marks question, it is a 4 marks question. And 4 marks are very, you can say, scoring one in gate. Out of 100, if you are able to score 4 marks in some 3, 4, 5 minutes, it will be good for you. So it will take some time for carrying out this calculation. But question is very easy. Question is not difficult. What you need to first find out? The actual work by the compressor. It will be the isentropic work by the isentropic efficiency of the compressor. You will get this answer. What is the efficiency? How you will get the efficiency? What is the efficiency expression? You know, it is W net by heat supplied. Okay. So what is W net? It is this. What is heat supplied? This. So if you will put old temperature, If you will put old temperature, how to get, what is T3? T3 is given to you. T3 is given to you for 1400 Kelvin. T1 is given to you. How to find out T2? That I have already explained to you. If you will use this expression, you will be able to find out T2 dash. How to find out T4 dash? You will find out actual work of the turbine also. Because if you will find out the, you can say, isentropic efficiency of the turbine. So it will be W actual by W isentropic. What is isentropic work? That you can find out from this. T3 minus T4. Cp T3 minus T4. So this you can find out. Okay. So I can write this in terms of temperature also. This is T3 minus T4. T3 minus T4 divided by T3 minus T4 dash divided by T3 minus T4. Because what is actual work? Actual work is Cp T3 minus T4 dash. So Cp Cp will be cancelled out in both cases. So this ratio you will get T3 minus T4 dash divided by T3 minus T4. So what is T4? Can you find out? Easily you can find out. Okay. This easily you can find out. Because T4 is T3 by Rp ki power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So you can easily find out this T4. Okay. So in this case, this efficiency is given to you. This is also 0.8. Both compressor and turbine are having isentropic efficiency 0.8. So you will be able to find out this T4 dash from this. Yes, anybody getting answer? Anybody is getting answer? Yes. So if you will solve this, you will get this answer. You will get this answer. Here I am writing. This will be the answer you will get. 24.8%. So you will get this efficiency will be 0.248. Just check it out and tell me everybody getting this answer. You will get efficiency 0.248. Okay. This is the efficiency expression you will get. Let's quickly move to next question. Quickly move to next question. This is comparatively easy one. This is easy one. This is comparatively easy one. You can answer. An ideal Brayton cycle operating between the pressure limit of 1 bar and 6 bar has minimum and maximum temperature of 300 and 1500 Kelvin. The ratio of specific heats of the working fluid is 1.4. The approximate final temperature in Kelvin at the end of compression and expansion. This is very easy one. This is comparatively very easy. Okay. So if you want to take this screenshot, you can take. If anybody want to note it down, they can take the screenshot of this. Yes, Kameshwari, good. It is close to 23. Close to 23, yes. You can answer this. Na? Option A will be right. It is close to 23, but right answer you will get. Exactly, you will get this answer. Exactly, you will get this answer. 24.8. Good. With 23 also, because this is an options are given to you. So you can answer option A. For this, option C is right. For this, option A is right. Okay, let's move to next question, you know. So this is comparatively easy one. An ideal Brayton cycle operating between the pressure limits of 1 bar and 6 bar. Okay, so he asked you to find out the temperature, exit temperature. So TS. So what is given in this Brayton cycle? The pressure ratios are 1 and 6. So what I can say, the RP is 6, yes or no? The inlet pressure is 1, the exit pressure is 6 bar. So the pressure ratio is 6. Minimum and maximum temperature. Minimum kahan pe hota hai? At the entry of the compressor. So T1 is 300. This is given to you. Maximum kahan pe hota hai? Inlet of turbine pe. So T3 is given to you. It is, you can say 1500 Kelvin. Where you will get minimum temperature? At the entry of the compressor. It is 27, you know. It is atmospheric temperature, atmospheric pressure. 1 bar close to, normally the inlet to the compressor is atmospheric air only. So it is close to 27 degrees Celsius. Okay. So 15 is the highest temperature. Specific heat gamma is given to you 1.4. Okay. The approximate final temperature in Kelvin at the end of the compression. So just you need to find out this. 2 and 3. Find out T2. Sorry, this is T, not 3. This is 4. This is 4. Okay. So just find out this T4. So find out T2 and T4. What approximate value you are getting? this is comparatively easy one. You can solve this in not more, even in 1 minute, less than 1 minute, you can solve. Yes, anybody getting right answer? Yes, try to solve this question. What you are getting? Yes, Rohit is saying option A. Very right, Rohit. Good. Option A is right. Option A is right. You will get this answer. Option A. So T2 will come out close to 500. Close to it will not come out to exact 500. You know, because he has clearly mentioned what will be the approximate final temperature. Clearly, he has mentioned find out the approximate final temperature. So approximate final temperature will come out 500. This temperature will come out close to 500. This will come out close to 900. And you know how to solve this? Very easy. Because what is T2? T2 is T1 times RP power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Okay. What is T4? T4 is T3 by RP power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So this is also, this is given to you. T1 is given to you 300. So 300 into 6 power 2 by 7. Okay. And this is again T3. What is T3? T3 is 1500. So 1500 by 6 ki power 2 by 7. Okay. So if you will solve this, you will get. If you will solve this, you will get T2 and T5, T4 close to this. So yes, yes. Brit Singh is also getting A. Good. Yes, Brit, very right. Yes, Kameshwari, all are getting right answer. Good. Let's move to next question. Question number 10, I think. Yes, this you can answer in second only. This you can answer in second only. In second, you can answer. Yes. What is the pressure ratio of a gas turbine power plant corresponding to maximum work output? What is the pressure ratio? So what is the pressure ratio? So yes, any answer from your side? Okay, so what is pressure ratio? RP optimum in case of when you will get a maximum work. So when you are getting maximum work, what is the pressure ratio? Pressure ratio is RP optimum. RP optimum is the pressure ratio where the work is maximum. And this is, what is this? This is under root RP max. Okay. Or what you can say, this is RP max power 1/2. Yes or no? Or what is RP max? RP max is T2. Or you can say T max by T minimum. But what you need to come, need to keep in mind for pressure, when you will write T2 by T1, it will be T2 by P1 ki power gamma minus 1 by gamma. But when you will write the pressure ratio, so it will be T max by T minimum ki power gamma by gamma minus 1. Yes or no? When you will write the pressure ratio, T2 by T1 is P2 by P1 ki power gamma minus 1 by gamma. But if you want to write the pressure ratio, so pressure ratio is P2 by P1 is T2 by T1 ki power gamma by gamma minus 1. Okay. But under root is also there. So power is 1/2. Power 1/2. Okay. So this is your RP max. Max ki power 1/2. So what answer you are getting? Yes. Bridge, Kameshwari, all are saying option A. Yes. This is right. Option A is right. This is right. Option A is right. Okay. Let's move to next question. This is slightly tricky. Don't do mistake in this. What basic mistake you will do? Don't do that. I'm not telling you what mistake you will do. First, try to solve. Okay. Then tell me what answer you are getting. In a gas turbine power plant, hot combustion product with a specific heat CV this. Kilojoule per kg Kelvin, enter the turbine at 20 bar, 1500 Kelvin. Exit at 1 bar. The isentropic efficiency of the turbine is 0.94. The work developed by the turbine per kg of the gas flow. What is the work developed by the turbine per kg of the gas flow? So can you find out this? Okay, try to solve what you are getting. Just tell me. Yes, so how to solve this particular question? So first, draw the cycle. You know what is a cycle? Cycle is like this. so that you will not do mistake. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Okay, this is 4. Okay, so this cycle is something like this. Okay, so but in this case the isentropic efficiencies are mentioned. So this expansion process will be like this. The expansion in the turbine is like this. So this point 4 dash you will get. This is the expansion which is taking place in the turbine. Okay. So you know what is isentropic efficiency of the turbine? Isentropic efficiency of the turbine. What is this? This is W, you can say actual by W isentropic. W actual by W isentropic. What is actual work? Actual work you are getting. It is Cp T3 minus T4. Or put here W actual only. W actual, because you want to find out this. You want to find out this expression. W actual to main nikalna hai na. What is the work developed by the turbine? So we want to find out this W actual. What is isentropic work? Isentropic work is Cp T3 minus T4. T3 minus T4. If you will put a T4 here, then it is right. Because it is isentropic efficiency. What is isentropic efficiency? Isentropic work? Isentropic work is Cp T3 minus T4. Okay. But where you will do mistake, if you will put here WA by Cp, T3 if you will take common, and you can write it as 1 minus, this will be T3 by Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. This is the expression. So what is T3? T3 is the entry to the turbine. T3 is the entry to the turbine. This is given. Because I have taken T3 common. So this will be T3. I have taken common. So 1 minus 1 by Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Okay. So this you will get. So T3 is given to you. Cp is also given to you. But don't put it 1 or 1.05. If Cp is given 0.98, put it 0.98 only. So this Cp is 0.98. First thing, where student will do mistake. This is 0.98. Put it 0.98 only. This is 1500. Okay. What is Rp given? Rp is also given to you. The entry to the turbine is 20 bar and exit is 1 bar. Entry is at 20 bar. Exit is at 1 bar. So what is the pressure ratio? Pressure ratio is high pressure to the low pressure. So pressure ratio is 20 only. So this is 20. This is 20. But what gamma you will put here? What gamma you will... Don't put gamma 1.3. If you will put gamma 1.3, you will get wrong answer. Yes, Kameshwar is getting right answer. 689. So don't put gamma 1.4. You need to put gamma equal to Cp by Cv. What is Cp given? Cp given is 0.98. What is Cv given? Cv given is 0.7538. If you will solve this, you will get answer close to 1.3. You will get answer close to 1.3. Just check it out. Tell me what you are getting. So gamma will come out this. So you need to put gamma 1.3 only. Don't put gamma 1.4. So if you will put all values like W actual, you want to find out what is isentropic efficiency given. Isentropic efficiency is given is 0.94. This is given to you. Isentropic efficiency is 0.94. So this is given. This is given. This is given. This also given. W actual you can easily find out. Very easy one. Yes, Kameshwari, the answer is right. Option A is right. You will get this answer. So W actual will come out close to this 689.64 kilojoule per kg. This is the answer. Okay. Let's move to next question. This is comparatively easy from year 2002. Only one question is remaining. One question is remaining, you know? After 2002, one more question I think is there related to year 2001. An ideal air standard regenerative Brayton cycle is working between minimum and maximum temperature of 300 Kelvin and 1200 Kelvin respectively. Find out the value of critical pressure ratio where the degree of regeneration becomes zero. One concept we will discuss from this. I have discussed, but what is this? What is the meaning of this? That I will also tell you. What is the meaning of this degree of regeneration where it will become zero? So find out the value of the critical pressure ratio where the degree of regeneration becomes zero. Calculate the efficiency of the cycle when the operating pressure is 60% of the critical pressure ratio. What is that critical pressure ratio? I will discuss, and if you know, try to solve it. Okay. Critical pressure ratio. So let me draw the expression for efficiencies versus RP. So if I will draw expression of efficiency versus RP, what expression you are getting for the efficiency of simple Brayton? So efficiency expression for simple Brayton is something like this. This is the expression for efficiency for simple Brayton. This type of expression. This is simple Brayton. So with increasing RP, efficiency increases. Why? Because in simple Brayton, what is the efficiency? 1 minus 1 by RP ki power gamma minus 1. So if RP increases, the 1 by RP ki power gamma minus 1, that will decrease. So if that will decrease, the efficiency will increase. So this is the expression for simple Brayton. But what type of expression, what type of curve you will get? What type of curve you will get for regenerative cycle? So regenerative cycle curve is something like this, you know. Okay, let me draw it with a different color. Okay, so this is for regenerative. This type of curve. This is for regenerative. Here I am writing regenerative cycle. So regenerative cycle efficiency, this is maximum. Where it is maximum? At RP equal to 1. Regenerative cycle efficiency is maximum at RP equal to 1. Or what you can say? C equal to 1. When RP equal to 1, so C is also equal to 1. What is C? C is the temperature ratio of the compressor. Exit temperature of the compressor by inlet temperature of the compressor. So add this. Where you will get regenerative cycle efficiency maximum? It is at this point. Okay, so this pressure is the critical pressure. Why this is the critical pressure? Because after that point, you will start getting efficiency even less than the simple Brayton. Yes or no? So if you are increasing, if this pressure ratio is more than this, this is particular pressure ratio. If your pressure ratio is more than this, so this cycle, simple Brayton cycle efficiency will be more. In that case, regenerative cycle will not work. So regeneration will not work. Why regeneration will not work? Because the pressure ratio is very high. So pressure ratio is very high. So the exit temperature at the end of the compressor will be high. Because compressor ratio is high. This RP is high. So C will be high. Yes or no? RP is high. So C will be high. So C high means the exit temperature of the compressor will be high. It means when it is high, so there you want to heat na? You want to heat the gases which are coming out from the compressor before entering into the combustion chamber. So if that RP is high enough, temperature is high enough, so the reverse transfer of heat will take place. The heat transfer will take place from compressor gases to the exhaust gases. Getting a point? So this is particular, you can say RP critical. After that, you will start getting efficiency less than the simple Brayton. So this he is asking you. This he is asking you. So can you find out this? Can you find out this? Okay, simply same expression like the earlier one, if you will use for RP, same RP optimum type expression, if you will use, you will get. Okay, so here I'm writing. So what you will get? You will get here, I'm writing T max by T minimum power. What you can say? Gamma by 2 times of gamma minus 1. So you will get RP critical from this. Okay. Because at this point, what is C here? What is C here? C is under root T. We have discussed at this point C is under root T. What is under root T? It is T ki power 1 by 2. T ki power 1 by 2. So this will be this only, because RP you want to find out. So what is RP? RP is C ki power gamma by gamma minus 1. But this under root is also there. Okay. So you will get RP from this. Yes, Rohit is getting 11.3. Very right, Rohit. 11, yes, RP you will get, yes. 11.3 something, 11.31. Yes, right. You will get this. So for this first question, answer is this 11.3. So calculate, solve this second question also. What is the cycle efficiency when the operating pressure is 60% of the critical pressure? Calculate cycle efficiency. So what is operating pressure, if I will ask you? Operating pressure ratio, it is 0.6 of the RP critical. So this you have already find out 11.631. This is 0.6. So if you will solve this, what you are getting? This is the RP actual. Okay, RP actual. So what you are getting, I think this will come out 6.78. This will come out 6.7882, close to this. You will get RP. Yes, yes, Rohit, very right. 6.78. So just tell me what is the efficiency. अब यहाँ पे एक mistake मत करना. You want to find out efficiency. For what you want to find out efficiency? Just keep in mind that thing. First solve, then I will tell you what type of mistake you can do in this. So first find out efficiency. This is the RP actual, you can say. RP actual. This is the 60% of the RP critical. So this is the ratio you are getting. Find out the efficiency. Yes, anybody getting answer? Anybody is getting answer? Okay, so what mistake you will do in this? If you will solve it by 1 minus 1 by RP actual by power gamma minus 1, that is wrong basically. Because he has clearly mentioned the cycle is regenerative Brayton cycle, air standard regenerative cycle. So the cycle is air standard regenerative cycle. Getting the point? Cycle is not simple Brayton. Cycle is air standard regenerative cycle. So air standard regenerative cycle is working on this particular RP. Getting the point? Air standard regenerative cycle is working on this RP. So don't use formula 1 minus 1 by RP ki power gamma minus 1. If you will use, you will get wrong answer. So what formula you need to use? The efficiency of regenerative cycle. And what is the efficiency of regenerative cycle? It is 1 minus T minimum by T maximum into RP power gamma minus 1 by gamma. You need to use this expression. Because what is this? This is nothing but this is 1 minus C by T. 1 minus C by T. What is C? C is this RP power gamma minus 1 by gamma. What is T? T is T max by T minimum. So if you will write here T max by T minimum, so T minimum you can write in numerator. So this will be, expression will be like this. 1 minus T minimum by T maximum into RP power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So you need to use this expression. Why? Because it is clearly mentioned the cycle is regenerative cycle. Air standard regenerative cycle. So if you will use this formula, you will get right answer. Yes, Rohit had made the same mistake. Yes, that's why I'm telling you. This is general mistake. You need to read this particular point. Air standard regenerative cycle. Air standard regenerative Brayton cycle. I think it is now clear to all. Yes, Rohit, what answer you are getting now? Just tell me. Air standard. Yes, everybody, all. Kameshwari Bridge. So all are getting any answer. So what efficiency you are getting? Just tell me the efficiency. So it will come out close to 0.5678. If you will check it, it will come out 5678. It will come out close to 5678. 0.5678. You will get this answer. Okay. Or what you can say? 56.789%. 56.789%. I think all are getting this answer. We can move to last question. Then we will discuss some concept related to steam turbine power plant. Yes, Rohit, now your answer is right. Now your answer is right. 56.789. This is right. Okay, so this is our last question from year 2000, I think. Just check it out. Okay, so no, this we have already discussed. Yes, this is our last question from year 2001. Yes. So I have taken all questions related to gas turbine from year 2001 to 19. If anybody, any question is not there, okay, it may be the chance some questions are not there, but I think most of the questions from year 2001 to 2000 we have covered. So just try to answer this question also. I think that similar type of question we have discussed in engineering services section only also. This type of question, I think earlier also we have discussed, so I'm not taking so much time on this. You can try to solve. You can try to solve. So what answer you are getting? What is work actually? What is network? What is network in, you can say, Brayton cycle or gas turbine power plant? Suppose this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. Okay. The cycle will be something like this. So what is network? Network is WT minus WC. What is WT? WT is CP T3 minus T4. What is WC? WC is CP T2 minus T1. If the cycle is ideal, air standard ideal Brayton cycle. Okay. So this is the network. And I can write it as like this also, Cp into T3 minus T4 minus T2 plus T1. Yes or no? I can write a W net as like this. But he has given the work in kilowatt. This is not the specific work. The find the airflow required for 100 kilowatt power output. What is the meaning of power? When he's saying power output, it is not the turbine work. It is the network. Okay. It is the network. Turbine work, he will mention like turbine work is this, compressor work is this. When he's saying power output is this, what is the power output of a turbine? Power output of a power plant. It is not the turbine output. It is the network output. That is the power which what you will get from a power plant. So this is 100 kilowatt. Okay, and when it is given in 100 kilowatt, so you need to take mass also here. You need to take mass also here. Why? Because then only you will get this in kilowatt. If you will not take mass here, you will get work output in kilowatt per kg. If you will not take mass here, you will get work in kilowatt per kg. Okay, so this is 100. If you will solve this 100 equal to m dot a. M dot a you want to find out. What is Cp? Cp here is 1. Only use this in 1 only. What is T3? T3 is the maximum temperature. Maximum temperature. Maximum temperature is 1000 degrees Celsius. So it is 1273. Minus what is T4? T4 you need to find out. Aapko find out karna padega. What is T2? T2 bhi aapko find out karna padega. What is T1? T1 aapko given as 27 degrees Celsius. So this will be 300. This will be 300. From this, you can easily find out m dot a. You can easily find out m dot a. Because if you will put values of T4 and T2, you will get answer. How to find out T4? T4 is T3 by Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So what is T3? T3 is 1273. What is Rp here? Rp here is, yes, 4. Pressure ratio is 4. So 4 power 2 by 7. Because the gamma is mentioned here is 1.7 only. Gamma is 1.4. Yes, gamma is 1.4. So you can use this. So from this, you can calculate. You can calculate T4. You can calculate T4. Similarly, how to calculate? How to find out T2? How to find out T2? So T2 will be T1 into Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So this is 300 into what is Rp? Rp is 4. Power 2 by 7. So if you will solve this, you will get T2. If you will solve this, you will get T4. And if you will put all values of T4 and T2 here, you will get a mass flow rate of the air. You will get a mass flow rate of the air. Okay. Getting answers? You will get a mass flow rate of the air. Just try to solve and tell me what answer you are getting. Okay, so if you will solve this, you will get 0.3696 kg per second. If you will solve this, you will get this answer. Mass flow rate of the air will come out point. Yes, Kameshwari answer is right, close to 0.37. Yes, very right. 0.3696. This is exact. 0.37 is also right. 0.37 is right answer. Rohit is also getting right answer. Yes, Rohit answer is exact 0.396. Good. 0.3696. Both are right. So friend, this is about, you can say important question. Like what you can say, all previous year gate questions we have discussed. Okay. From year 2000 to 2019, related to this particular topic, gas turbine, we have discussed gas turbine power plant. Okay. So now let's start our next topic, you know, steam turbine power plant. So I will discuss with you some basics of the steam turbine power plant. And I will suggest you to go through some basic concept of the thermodynamics. Basic concept of the, you can say how to calculate the properties of pure substances in wet region, superheated region. If you will revise all these things in this coming week, then in next Saturday, we will start with, you can say steam power plant. But in today's class, we will discuss it about the introduction. What is steam power plant? How that basic system works? Okay. And why we need to discuss that particular, you can say, properties of pure substances related to wet region, superheated region. And on what cycle this particular US steam turbine works. Okay, so let me take that particular first discuss with you what is a cycle. Okay, so what is the meaning? If I will ask you, what is the meaning of a steam turbine power plant? Steam turbine power plant. of a steam turbine power plant. देखो, इन गैस टर्बाइन पावर प्लांट अवर वर्किंग मीडियम इज गैस और एयर, व्हाट यू कैन से इन एयर और एयर फ्यूल मिक्सचर द कंबशन इज टेकिंग प्लेस इन द कंबशन चैम्बर एंड वी आर जनरेटिंग हीट एंड बाय हीट दैट हीट द प्रेशर इज राइजिंग ऑफ द गैस एंड वी आर एक्सपेंडिंग दैट गैस इनटू द गैस टर्बाइन. ओके, बट इन स्टीम टर्बाइन पावर प्लांट दैट इज बेसिकली क्लोज्ड साइकिल एज कंपेयर टू ओपन साइकिल गैस टर्बाइन बिकॉज द कंबशन गैसेज आर डायरेक्टली गोइंग इनटू द टर्बाइन. The gas in which you are carrying out combustion, that same gas is going into the turbine. So this gas turbine is not an external combustion heat engine. Gas turbine is an internal combustion. So let's say open cycle. There is closed cycle gas turbine also. Open cycle gas turbine is an internal combustion engine. It is not an external combustion engine. Because in which gas you are carrying out combustion, the same gas is moving into the turbine. Or you can say expansion device. But in case of steam turbine power plant, the combustion you are carrying out of the coil or any solid fuel which but you can burn. So you are carrying out combustion of the solid fuel and you are generating flue gases. In any thermal power plant, if you will visit, you will find there is a combustion chamber and you are carrying out combustion of the fuel coil. So there is also we are using fuel because without energy input, no output is possible. You know, that is first law of thermodynamics. Without input, output is not possible. What is second law? Input cannot be converted into 100% output. The input cannot be converted into output completely. That is second law of thermodynamics. But you can say tell in one single line. Okay. So input is required and that input is required in the form of the solid fuel. Generally we use coil because coil is available in our country, but it is not of good quality, but it is available. So that coil we use to generate hot gases or what you can say flue gases. So by burning of the coil, we generate flue gases. Okay, and these flue gases will go into the boiler section where the transfer of heat takes place from those flue gases to the water and we will generate steam by utilizing that heat of the burnt out gases or what you can say flue gases. By utilizing that heat, you can say the water is converted into steam and that the steam is moved into the turbine. So getting point. So why it is an external combustion engine? Because the flue gases are not going into the turbine. We are not expanding flue gases into the turbine. Rather, we are utilizing the heat of the steam gases, the heat of the flue gases to heat water or convert it into steam, and then that steam will go into the turbine. Getting a point? So what type of cycle on which it is not an open cycle, it is a closed cycle and it is a not an internal combustion heat engine, it is an external combustion heat engine. Why I am saying it is also a heat engine? Because what is heat engine? Heat engine is a device or engine which convert chemical energy of the fuel into mechanical work. Here also we are converting chemical energy. What chemical energy? Chemical energy of the coil into mechanical work. We are producing mechanical work and we are utilizing that mechanical work to convert electricity by attaching a generator with the, you can say, turbine. Okay, so we are producing electricity, both, like say gas turbine power plant, your steam turbine power plant, our main function is to produce electricity. Okay, so what you need to keep in mind, here the working medium is steam in general. The working medium is steam. It may be in the form of, you can say, saturated in, like when you are pumping water into the boiler, condenser, at the exit of the condenser, what you will get? You will get liquid and that liquid will be pumped into the boiler. So from condenser exit to the boiler input, what you are having? You are having water. Getting point? Condenser exit to the boiler input, you are having water. In boiler, heat addition is taking place. So phase change is taking place. Boiler mein kya hoga? Phase change hoga. Kahan se kahan? Liquid to vapor. It may be saturated vapor, it may be superheated vapor, depending on the, you can say, case maybe. Getting a point? But in this case, the boiling will take place. But you can say heat addition takes place. And what is the ideal process for a boiler? It is constant pressure also. Like the combustion chamber in gas turbine we have discussed, here also the heat addition in the boiler takes place at constant pressure. Getting a point? But in this case, the change in phase is taking place. It is not an air-centered cycle. Why? Because the working medium is not air. In gas turbine power cycle, the working medium is air. That's why there is no need of showing this type of like curve. We generally draw the cycle here. When we will draw Brayton cycle, it is only drawn here. Because what do you know? Air is in superheated stage. Na? Air is in superheated stage. So we draw cycle like this. There is no need of drawing this. Why? Because air will remain in air only. In gas turbine power plant, in auto cycle, in diesel cycle, in dual cycle, in this particular, you can say gas turbine Brayton cycle, or Bell Coleman cycle, reverse Brayton cycle in refrigeration also, because they are also air refrigeration cycle, there is no change in phase taking place. Getting point? So when there is no change in phase taking place, there is no need of showing this saturation curve. There is no need of showing this any type of this saturation curve. Okay, but in this cycle, Rankine cycle, the change in phase is taking place. Change in phase is taking place in the boiler. Then that's why we need to take the saturation curve. So if you will check any cycle, steam turbine cycle, you will find some curve like this. You will find some curve like this. And in this point, it is mentioned like that x equal to 0. And in this, it is mentioned that x equal to 1. At this point x equal to 0, this point x equal to 1. And then you will draw your cycle in between. So this is temperature, this is entropy. Then you will draw your cycle in between these two curves. This is the saturated liquid curve. This is saturated vapor curve. For saturated liquid curve, x equal to 0. For saturated vapor curve, you are having saturated vapor. So total mass is converted into vapor. So x is 1. What is x? X is the dryness fraction. And what is x? If I write here, x is mass of vapor to the mass of vapor plus mass of air. If there is no mass of vapor, then x will be 0. Yes or no? So this is the curve of the saturated liquid. In this region, entire is liquid. In this region, this side entire is, you can say, gas. There is gas or vapor, what you can say. Gas or what you can say? Vapor. It is better to write vapor here. Vapor. Okay. But in this region, what you are having? You are having liquid plus vapor. This is known as wet region. This is known as subcooled or liquid region. This is known as superheated or vapor region. Getting point? So this region is wet. Wet region. Because in this region, we are having mixture of vapor plus air. In this region, we are having liquid. In this region, we are having vapor. And then you need to draw your cycle. So x at this point, because total mass is only in the form of liquid. And any point which lie in this point, it is in liquid form. So at this point, x is 0. Because x is mv by mv, v plus ma. This is the total mass. Mass of vapor plus mass of air. At this point, total mass is in form of, total mass is in the form of, what you can say? Vapor only. So this is 0. There is no air. What you can say? There is no gas. It is better to write liquid here. Better to write liquid because this is the mass of vapor by mass of vapor plus mass of liquid. What is x? X is mass of vapor. Vapor, what you can say? Gas. Vapor by vapor plus liquid. So at this point, total is, what you can say? Total, what you are getting? Mass of vapor is 0. At this point, mass of liquid is 0. So mv by mv, what you will get? X equal to 1. Getting point? So then you need to draw your cycle. You need to draw your cycle taking these two curves. I think it is now clear why we need to take this curve. Okay. Now, this is the particular cycle. This is the particular, you can say, diagram, schematic diagram for any steam turbine power plant. You need to first know the basic component of a steam power plant and how that particular system works. Then I will draw that cycle also for you. So cycle is very easy. You can easily carry out calculation. I will discuss it with you. So what is the main component? If I will ask you, suppose there is some, what you can say, some here, few gases will enter. What are these? These are few gases. These are few gases. Okay. These are few gases. So few gases are entering here. Few gases are entering here. Okay. And here, what you can say? It is the boiler section. In boiler section. In boiler section, what you will do? What are the important devices which are there? What you can say? There will be some, air preheater will be there. This liquid heater will be there, which will initially preheat it. Then there will be some evaporator section in which there will be change in phase of this particular liquid will take place. The change in phase will, because this is the condenser. What is this? This is your condenser. At the exit of the condenser, you will have liquid. Exit of the condenser, you will have liquid. Okay, I will tell you why you are getting this liquid. And this liquid will be pumped. This is pump basically. This liquid will be pumped to the boiler pressure. At this, you are having condenser pressure. At this point, you are having condenser pressure. At this point, you are having boiler pressure. So this liquid is pumped to the boiler pressure with the help of the pump. Obviously, it will require some work, but that is very less as compared to the work required in the gas turbine power plant. Because in gas turbine power plant, we are having compressor. So compressor work is minus VDP. Because that is also an open system device. This is also an open device minus VDP. But the V, specific volume for the liquids are very less. And specific volume for the gases are very high. If you will compare, if you will check it out, you will able to find out. If I will give you 1 liter of, you can say, liquid. 1 liter of liquid. So 1 liter of liquid, can you find out the specific volume? Suppose if I will consider some liquid and it's having some, you can say specific volume one. What is specific volume? Volume per unit mass. Volume per unit mass. Okay. So if you are having suppose specific volume one of some liquid, if you will convert it into steam, the specific volume will, you can say, will be increased up to 16 to 1500 times. It may be 2000 times also. Getting the point? So when you are converting change in phase, when you are converting a liquid into vapor, there is a sharp change in the specific volume will take place. Liquid specific volume is very less. If you will take one, the volume which you will get for vapor, if you will convert entire liquid into vapor, the specific volume will be 1500 to 2000 times of that of the specific volume of the liquid. So that's why the compressor work is very high in case of gas turbine power plant, and we cannot neglect that. But in this case, the pump work is very less because the specific volume is less, because you are pumping a liquid, not a vapor. Okay, so this is, you can say, this liquid will be pumped into the boiler, then it there the first, you can say, preheating will take place, then evaporator, you can say, the change in phase take place, and then there will be some superheater where the superheating of the steam will take place. So you can say there is some, you can say, preheater is there, evaporator section is there, and then what you can say, there is, this is the superheated section. So preheated section, evaporator section, and superheated section. Preheated, you will heat water at some high temperature, then evaporator means the change in phase will take place from liquid to vapor, then you will superheat it. Okay, so then it will go into the turbine. The steam will go into, and why it will, why that particular change in phase is taking place? Because you are utilizing flue gases. Where these flue gases are coming? They are coming from your combustion chamber. There is some reason where you are carrying out the combustion. Okay, so from that combustion chamber, flue gases are coming, and they are hot gases basically. What you can say? They are hot gases. Okay, so when these hot gases will, you will pass on the tubes of the boiler. Boiler are different type of boiler. We will discuss it later on. But first, what you need to know, like any type of boiler, maybe hot gas is entering, so there will be transfer of heat, because they are at high temperature, this is at low temperature, there will be transfer of heat takes place. So there will, we will get change in phase. So we will get here, what we will get here? Superheated or saturated steam. It may be saturated steam or superheated steam, depending on the heat supplied. How much heat you are supplying at this point, you may get superheated steam or saturated steam. Getting a point? So this superheated or saturated steam will enter into the turbine, where the expansion of those steam will take place. So this is a steam turbine basically, where you are carrying out the expansion of the steam. And when you will carry out the expansion of the steam, so there will be drop in enthalpy. You will get some work output. If you will apply steady flow energy equation, because this is also an open device, open system. Turbine is also an open device. Okay, flow system, you can say, flow device. Because it is not a closed system. So you can apply steady flow energy equation. So if you apply steady flow energy equation here, what you will get? Work developed by the turbine is the enthalpy in minus enthalpy out. So how much work you are developing from a turbine? It is nothing but the enthalpy in minus enthalpy out. If you will neglect the kinetic energy and potential energy changes, getting point? This expression only you can write if the kinetic energy and potential energy changes are neglected, and you are assuming that there is no heat transfer from the turbine. There is no heat transfer. Q is zero. Means we are assuming the expansion is adiabatic. When the expansion is adiabatic, what do you can say? The enthalpy in plus kinetic energy potential energy changes are neglected. Q is also zero. So H1 equal to H2 plus WCV. So what is WCV? WCV will be H1 minus H2. I think it is now clear. You will get some work output because expansion of gases will take place. So some work you will get. Okay, and what is that work? That is the mechanical work. That is the rotation of the shaft. Okay, and by getting that work, you have connected a generator. It is a generator basically. And when you will supply mechanical energy to this generator, you will able to produce electricity. Okay, and that electricity you will supply to the some grid connected plant are there. So by this grid, there will be some transfer of the electric energy from one place to another place. But this is the main system, how it is working. At the exit of the turbine, what you will have? You will have steam only. It may be enter, like it may be like at the, you can say, saturated steam, or it may be slightly, you can say, dry. Or what you can say? Slightly wet, what you can say? Slightly wet means the exit turbine will be at this point. It may be at this point, okay, or it may be at this point. If the exit at this point turbine, so what you are having? You are having superheated, you can say that dry steam is exiting from the turbine. If the exit is at this point, what you can say? That steam which is getting exiting, that is the स्लाइटली वेट, स्लाइटली वेट मीन्स देखो इन दिस डायरेक्शन वेटनेस इज इंक्रीजिंग, इन दिस डायरेक्शन वेटनेस इज इंक्रीजिंग बिकॉज लिक्विड कंटेंट इज इंक्रीजिंग, सो दिस इज स्लाइटली वेट. इन दिस डायरेक्शन व्हेन यू विल से इन दिस डायरेक्शन ड्राइनेस इज इंक्रीजिंग, ड्राइनेस मीन्स वेपर कंटेंट इज इंक्रीजिंग, गेटिंग पॉइंट. सो व्हेन यू विल से इन दिस डायरेक्शन वेटनेस इंक्रीजेस, इन दिस डायरेक्शन ड्राइनेस इंक्रीजेस, सो दिस इज स्लाइटली वेट. And this is not allowed below x. This x, suppose if I say this x, so this x is not, is always greater than or what you can say equal to 0.8. In actual case, you will keep it close to 8.5. Obviously, it will be less than 1 or less than 1 because aap superheated to nahi chhodoge because you need to utilize. You want to utilize all energy. So what you can say ki this x is generally greater than 0.58, 0.58 or 0.8. Ab aisa nahi ki aap ye exit, you will exiting steam at, you can say 0.6 dryness fraction, 0.5 dryness fraction. It is not like that. Because if the exit of the steam, which is exiting from the train, the dryness fraction is 0.7, 0.6. Means there is a huge amount of liquid content in that particular mixture. And if the liquid content in the turbine is increasing, what it means? What is the liquid density? It is very high as compared to the vapor density. So when if I'll say 1 gram of vapor is striking, okay, so vapor density is very less. But when liquid, 1 gram, what you can say liquid, when it will strike, liquid will strike with the turbine, because if this point is in this region, wet region, less than this 0.85. So liquid will strike to the turbine. So what I want to say, the erosion of the turbine will take place. And you don't want that erosion. Erosion means simply there will be when that, because that velocity is very high. We are saying change in velocities are negligible. We are not saying ki velocities are zero. Bachche generally kya samajhte hai? Wo samajhte ki velocity is zero at turbine ke inlet. Agar velocity zero ki to how that fluid will flow? Getting point? Velocities are not zero. Potential energies are not zero. But the change in kinetic energies and change in potential energies are zero. Getting point? The velocity which is at the entry of the turbine is same as the velocity at the exit of the turbine. So when you will compare, when you will use steady flow energy equation, so KE1 equal to KE2, that is almost they are equal. So they will cancel out each other. Getting point? So velocity is very high. So when this high velocity liquid particle, when they will strike with your turbine blades, the material removal will take place. You know, material will be removed from the turbine. That is known as erosion. So erosion problem aa jati hai, that's why it is not allowed. Okay, so that point may be at this, or maybe at this, but not below 0.85. I think it is now clear. Okay, so this at this point, then what will enter? This particular steam. Rohit, thank you. Okay, this is also required, na? Motivation. So this point, at this point, what you will say? This steam, which is slightly wet, it is entering into the condenser. And in condenser, what is happening? The change in phase taking place. Change in phase. Why you are changing phase of this steam? If I will ask you why you are changing phase, if you will know, if any interview, any person will ask you why you are rejecting heat, then you want to supply heat in boiler, why you are rejecting heat? Getting a point? Some student can be confused in this. Like, why, when you need to supply heat in boiler, why you are rejecting? Why you are not supplying this steam directly into the boiler so that heat supplied will be less? Getting a point? This type of question can be asked. So what do you need to answer? Sir, if you will supply, first thing, that is not possible. Why? Because, sir, according to second law of thermodynamics, there is no cyclic device possible which is producing work without only interacting with the single reservoir. Means if we are not rejecting any heat, that is not possible. That is theoretically you can say. But if he will say you, no, I am not getting your point. Just tell me why practically it is not possible. Getting point? Theoretically, you can define that this is not possible. Without rejecting it, you cannot supply this to boiler. But practically, if we'll ask you, define it. How? Why it is not practically possible? So what you will say? Sir, if we will supply that steam directly into the boiler, so we need to attach a compressor here. Why? Because liquid cannot pump steam to the boiler. Because here at the turbine exit, we are having steam. So for pumping steam to the boiler, because this is the these are a different, you can say this is the boiler pressure at entry here, okay, at some boiler pressure, okay, then there is some, you can say, change in phase is taking place. I will draw the entire cycle. You will be able to draw very easily. So this is the inlet, this is the boiler pressure, okay, this is high as compared to this pressure because you have extracted, you have already extracted some work. So this pressure is less. This is the condenser pressure. This pressure, condenser pressure is less. Okay, so you cannot pump this steam directly into the boiler. You need to attach compressor. And if you will attach compressor, what problem you will have? The work what you are getting from the turbine, even you will require more work to supply into the compressor. That is one thing you can say. If you will attach compressor, the compressor work required will be even more than the work we are getting in the turbine. So then why to use this kind of system? Why will you use this kind of system if we are not getting any work output? Even we need to spend work. Getting point? So that is not desirable. Second, the condenser is a device which actually maintains the turbine pressure. Why? Because turbine is nothing. Turbine is a prime mover. Like there is a shaft, there is some, you can say, blades mounted, and you are carrying out expansion. So turbine is not carrying out expansion. Due to condenser, expansion is carrying out. What is the meaning of expansion? Means drop in pressure. Turbine is not carrying out the drop. This is the condenser which is maintaining the exit pressure of the turbine. Getting point? So if you will remove condenser, the exit pressure of the turbine will be high. There will be no expansion takes place. Getting? Why the turbine exit pressure is low? Why you will have a low pressure at the turbine exit? Because in liquid, in condenser, condensation will take place. When vapor will be converted into liquid, the pressure will drop. It will drop drastically. Getting point? So pressure is low, very. When you will compare this pressure, so this is the turbine inlet pressure. This is the condenser pressure. There is a huge difference in that pressure. So when liquid condensation will take place, then only you will able to maintain turbine exit pressure. If there is no condenser, the exit pressure of the turbine will be equal to the inlet pressure of the turbine. And that is equal to the boiler pressure. So everywhere there will be boiler pressure only. The steam you are supplying, steam you are getting. Steam you are supplying, steam you are getting. You are not getting any work input. Even you are spending huge amount of energy in you can say, boiler. There is no use of that kind of system. Getting a point? So practically it is not possible. I think it is now clear why we need to attach condenser. Because if you will remove condenser, this exit pressure cannot be maintained. If this exit pressure cannot be maintained, you will not get any work output. Okay. So condenser is there where you will supply. In condenser, what you will do? You will supply cold water. If you will see in first picture also, I have shown you the power plant. First slide you have seen, I will show it later on, that there is some thermal power plant is there and that is nearby to a river. If you will find any thermal power plant, if I will ask you where you will, if you want to install a thermal power plant, where you will install? You will install where there is a huge amount of availability of water is there. If water is not available, because in this particular, in boiler, you will require huge amount of water. In condenser, you require huge amount of water. If water is not available, then you will not install thermal power plant there. Okay, so this can be asked. So boiler for this particular thermal power plant, water requirement is very high. But for gas turbine power plant, you can, because there is no water water requirement is not there. Na? Open system is there, air is entering and air is available everywhere. Yes or no? Air is available everywhere. It is available in abundance. You can use air. Fuel which you are using, natural gas, that you can supply. That fuel you can supply by trucks, by pipelines, you can supply natural gas. You know, we are using LPG everywhere, every corner of the India, we are using LPG. How it is? Ujula scheme is there, for Pradhan Mantri, you know. So every place is we are using LPG. So what do you know? What I want to say, you can ensure the availability of natural gas. But if there is no water, you cannot ensure the availability because there is a huge amount of water required. So you are supplying, what you are supplying? You are supplying water. What water? It may be lake water, it may be river water, it may be some pond water. What is available to you? But you will not provide water which is available in the earth crust. So, okay, get a point. So, you will not provide water which, like, you will attach some, you suppose you, if you will say, sir, water is not available, can I attach some submersible pumps and can I extract water from the earth? This is not right, actually. Get a point? So, you are actually wasting the drinking water which is actually available in very less amount to us. So you need to use lake water, river water, or any pond water. Okay. So here, cold water will enter, obviously, but at which temperature it will enter? It will enter at atmospheric temperature. So you cannot reject the heat in this point below, you can say, atmospheric temperature. That is a limit. Because in this cycle, closed cycle, even you can drop some pressure, that is also there. You can drop this condenser pressure, you can drop up to some extent. As compared to, you can say, open cycle, you can drop. But you cannot drop so much that this water availability will be at very low temperature. Getting what? So, because if you will draw it to very low pressure, If you want to maintain condenser pressure very low, then you need to supply water also at very low temperature. When the condenser pressure will be very low, when the heat rejection will be high. So when heat rejection will be high, when that supply water temperature will be very low. So that is not in your hand. The water which is available in lakes or rivers, that is at atmospheric temperature. So you cannot drop this pressure up to very, you can say, if I will tell you, very low. You cannot drop it. You can drop it to slightly, but very high drop in condenser pressure is not possible. Because in that case, the water required will be at very low temperature. That is not possible. So in this case, the condensation will take place. The water, that low temperature will enter and the hot water will leave. And where the hot water will go? Hot water will go into the cooling tower. Cooling tower is a very important part. Yes, Rohit is saying, why not seawater? Seawater you can also use, but what are the problem with seawater? In seawater, you know, there are various type of salts are there. Okay, that can damage your tubes. Nah? In heat exchanger, what you are having? You need to treat that water. If you are using salty water, then you need to carry out the treatment. First, you need to attach the treatment plant, then you will supply. Directly, if you will use, you can say seawater, it can damage your this. There will be scaling formation is there. Okay, so that will damage. Generally, we don't use directly. Okay, so this hot water will go into the cooling turbine, and here this hot water will be cooled. How it will be cooled? By rejecting latent heat to the, what you can say, by rejecting latent, or what you can say, by rejecting sensibly to the air. So in air, there are induced fan. Yahan pe kya hote hain? Induced fan. Through this induced fan, air will be supplied. Through this induced fan, air, this level is slightly at height. If you will go to any thermal power plant, you will find this level. That this level of the cooling turbine is at some height. So there is some gap like this. This is the head, like where, and this section is there so that air can enter easily. So in this air, or some fan is there, so air is entering, and from top you are spraying water, hot water. Top you are spraying hot water. So there is a transfer which takes place, and that is like the evaporative cooling. If anybody will ask you how that cooling tower will work, it is like a evaporative cooling. What is evaporative cooling? So when this hot water will come in contact with the air, so what do you say? The evaporation of the some amount of water will take place. So there will be, that's why I'm saying the latent heat transfer will take place. So some liquid water will convert into the vapor. Okay. So latent, and when it will go, when it will convert into the vapor, what it will take? It will take latent heat with us, with it. So when a liquid is converted into vapor, it requires latent heat. Okay, so that's why there will be drop in temperature. Like your cooler. Your cooler is also an evaporative system. You are getting cooling effect in the cooler, air cooler. That is also you can say example of evaporative cooling. And like this also, there is a drop in water taking place by rejecting heat to the air, because some amount of water is leaving. Means all the times you need to add makeup water. That's what I'm saying. Because all the times, some of the water will be lost, now, and it is not in kg, it is in huge amount. Because you are carrying out the cooling of the cold water, because if there is no cooling carrying out, there will be no heat rejection. If there is no heat rejection, there will be, this condenser pressure will be high. If anybody will ask you, why you want to optimize heat in the condenser? If you are rejecting heat in the condenser, even less, we want to reject any minimum heat rejection which is possible. Okay, so but this, if this heat rejection is not optimum or not effective, if the heat rejection in the condenser is not effective, then this turbine exit pressure will be high, because this there will be, like, if heat rejection is not right, there will be no complete conversion of the vapor into the liquid. So this pressure will be high, and if this pressure will be high, the area of the cycle will be less. Yes or no? The area of the cycle will be less, so net work output will be less. You know, the area of the closed cycle, but it gives us the net heat transfer or net work transfer. So we want to maximize this area, and how we can increase this area? Can you answer two objective question? You can answer from this, how we can increase this area, by decreasing condenser pressure or by increasing boiler pressure? If you will able to increase boiler pressure, you can increase area, means network output will increase. If you will decrease condenser pressure, then also work input will increase. But both are having some limit. Why boiler pressure is having limit? Because when you will increase boiler pressure, the entry temperature to the turbine will also increase. And there is a limit. In turbine, in steam turbine, the exit to the entry to the turbine is limited to close to 650 only. एंट्री टू द टर्बाइन इज लिमिटेड टू 6 ड्यू टू मेटलर्जिकल लिमिट. अब कोई बच्चा पूछ सकता है सर व्हाई मेटलर्जिकल लिमिट्स आर डिफरेंट फॉर गैस टर्बाइन स्टीम टर्बाइन. फॉर गैस टर्बाइन आई एम सेइंग मेटलर्जिकल लिमिट्स आर क्लोज टू 1500 डिग्री सेल्सियस. दिस इज नॉट ए गैस टर्बाइन, दिस इज स्टीम टर्बाइन. ओके, सो द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ए टर्बाइन, व्हेन वी आर सेइंग ए टर्बाइन, टर्बाइन इज सिंपली ए डिवाइस, रोटरी डिवाइस इन विच वी आर कैरिंग आउट एक्सपेंशन, बट द इंटीरियर स्ट्रक्चर इज डिफरेंट. Okay, so in steam turbine, the entry to the turbine is maximum, max to max is 650 only. Okay, it is not high. But in gas turbine, it is in the range of 1500 degrees Celsius. In reciprocating engine, the turbine, the temperature, it is, there is no turbine, there is a reciprocating engine, but the temperature may be in the range of 2500. It is quite higher than the temperature in the steam turbine power plant and this. Getting a point? So this temperature is cannot be go beyond this. So you cannot increase, you can say this boiler pressure beyond that so that you will get temperature more than this. And similarly, you cannot drop this condenser pressure beyond a certain limit. Why? Because if you will drop this very low, suppose if you want to maintain vacuum there. If you want to maintain vacuum there, in that case, you need to supply water at a very low temperature, even less than 27 degrees Celsius. Okay, that is not possible. How you will provide water in the condenser less than 27 degrees Celsius? Only way is to carry out the refrigeration. Means you want to get some work output, but there you need to supply work output, work, because refrigeration you cannot produce without any work input. Getting point? So that here the temperature inlet temperature to the condenser is limited to the atmospheric temperature. Okay, so this is limited to the atmospheric temperature. That's why this is also limited. You can drop it to some atmospheric pressure, close to atmospheric pressure, but vacuum is not possible. Okay, so after that, this liquid will go into the pump and you will pump this liquid into the boiler. Okay, so here the boiler pressure is there. Liquid is entering and again you are preheating it. You are changing its phase. You are again superheating it and then it is going into the turbine. I think this cycle is clear to you. This cycle is, now I can draw this particular cycle. Okay, I think it is now clear to you. And burnt out gases, they will enter here and they will go from the chimney. Okay, there may be different type of system there. Like you may utilize some waste heat. Ab is waste ko it ko bhi utilize kar sakte ho by carrying out some type of regeneration system that we have discussed in gas turbine power plant. Same type of regenerative system you can use here also. You can utilize waste heat to carry out the, like you can attach some economizer here. Okay, air preheater can be there. So using there, like you can heat air which is entering into the, you can say your combustion chamber, the atmospheric air which is entering into the combustion chamber, you can heat that air. Getting point? So there may be different systems are there, but the basic systems are boiler, turbine, condenser and pump. These are the basic system. Different all attachments will be there. Okay, so let me show you the final cycle now. Let me show you the cycle and you will be easily able to analyze key why I have drawn this particular cycle like this. So this is the cycle on which you are this particular Rankine. This cycle name is Rankine cycle. There can be ideal Carnot cycle is also there, but that is the, you can say ideal cycle, not the practical cycle. Carnot cycle is the ideal cycle for any type of heat engine, whether it is a auto, diesel, any heat engine. That is the ideal cycle because it is the completely reversible cycle. But Carnot cycle is not practically possible. Why? Because if you will draw Carnot cycle will be something like this. Yes or no? Carnot cycle will be something like this. Okay. So this is the Carnot cycle. So in this case, you need to pump here liquid plus vapor. So that is not possible. You cannot pump liquid plus vapor by pump because pumps are used to circulate, what you can say? Liquids. Okay, so this is not possible. And if you will say, sir, why you are drawing like this? Why you are not drawing Carnot cycle like this? Why you are not drawing? So in this case, if I will draw Carnot cycle like this, your question can be like this, huh? Sir, in this case, I can say Carnot cycle is not practically possible. This Carnot cycle is not possible. Why Carnot cycle? This is not possible because you cannot pump liquid plus vapor, because in this reason here, you are having liquid plus vapor. You cannot pump liquid plus vapor by a pump. So this is not possible. This is not possible, you can say, okay, but why this is not possible? If I'm saying, if you are carrying out the superheating, there is only liquid, you can use pump, this, and it is possible. There is only liquid you are having, so can it is possible? This is also not possible. Why? Because this pump work is very high. In the Rankine cycle, this is the pump work only. This is the pump work, because this is the boiler pressure. This is the boiler pressure, okay, and heating is taking place at constant pressure, not at constant temperature. In Rankine cycle, heating is taking place at constant pressure. But if you want to use Carnot cycle, you need to here. Like, so this will be the pump work. Okay, so this 2' point will be here. So the pump work, if I will say pump work, in case of Carnot cycle, it will be minus V P2 dash minus P1. So this is point one. So this is the pump work. Okay, and this is quite high. This pump work is quite high. Very high pump work you are getting. So you cannot use practically Carnot cycle because this is the pump work and it is very high. Okay, but in case of Rankine cycle, what is the pump work? The pump work is this. This is the pump work, and the pump work is minus V, P2 minus P1. Okay, and what I want to say, it is P2 minus P1. This is less as compared to this. This P2 dash minus P1. Okay, so then also it is not possible. Why it is not possible? Because if you will supply liquid, there is no such kind of pump is there which can supply liquid plus vapor. Pump is there which can supply liquid. Compressor is there which can supply gases. There is no such kind of pump which can supply liquid plus vapor mixture. Any point? So wet reason is it is not possible. In this case also the work required will be high, and also practically it is very difficult to achieve this type of boiling. This type of boiling is not possible. Practically, this type of boiling is not possible because this is the boiling in the boiler at a constant temperature. So practically, boiling at constant temperature is not possible. This is work is very high. So that's why this cycle is not possible. If I will draw this type of cycle, and if I will draw this cycle in wet region, this is also not possible because this type of pump is not practically possible. So what you can say? Carnot cycle is ideal cycle. It gives us the limit that we can try to achieve. And what is Carnot cycle efficiency? It is 1 minus. Carnot cycle efficiency is 1 minus efficiency Carnot. It is 1 minus T lower by T higher. What is T lower? It is the temperature of the condenser. What is T higher? It is the temperature of the boiler. Because this is the temperature of the condenser. This is the lower temperature. And this is the higher temperature. Getting a point? So T lower is condenser temperature, T higher is boiler temperature. Okay. So this is the temperature efficiency of the Carnot cycle. Okay. Ideal cycle efficiency. But in this case, what is the Rankine cycle? Rankine cycle will be something like this. At the exit of the turbine, what I told you, at the exit of the turbine, you are having this. Suppose the expansion is carrying out isentropically. So this point you may have. This is the point, but this is limited. X is limited up to 0.8 or 0.85 only. X is limited to 0.85 only. So this is very close. This 4 point is very close to the saturated vapor curve. Okay. So this is the exit to the turbine. And how this particular, you can say this is the temperature versus entropy diagram. So this is entropy, temperature, and this is the temperature. Okay. Let me show you again. Okay, I think, yes, now we are having again. So this is the temperature in this, here I'm not writing. So this in this axis, we are having temperature. In this axis, we are having entropy. So there we are having temperature. Here I'm writing, so this, there is temperature, there is entropy. So here the expansion is isentropic. So entropy will remain constant. And then what you will have? Constant pressure heat rejection, change in phase takes place, and when change in phase takes place, so temperature is also constant and pressure is also constant. So in this point 4:1, temperature pressure both are constant, and then 1:2, what is 1:2? 1:2 is the pumping with the help of the pump. You are pumping water. So if I will show points here, you can show points here, like this is suppose here. So turbine exit, this is the 0.4, this is 0.1. Okay. Yes, this is 0.2. Okay, this is 0.2. This is 0.3. Okay, so cycle will be something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so this is the heat rejection in the condenser. Change in phase takes place. This is the, you will pump, because what is this pressure? This pressure is the condenser pressure, like this. The curve will be something like this. So this is the condenser pressure. What is this? This is the boiler pressure. So these are pressure curve. You know constant pressure curve kaise aati hai? Aise aati hai. Constant pressure curves are like this in TS diagram. So here you are pumping, you can say you are liquid into the boiler. Then again, change in phase takes place at constant pressure, 2 to 3 heat addition in the boiler. Here, heat rejection. Okay, so then 3 to 4 is the expansion in the turbine. Okay, now I think you will able to define the working, how that particular steam turbine power plants works, and what is the cycle, what is the name of the cycle? Rankine cycle. Okay, there may be different type depending on the like you may, in this case you are getting the, at the exit of the boiler you are getting superheated steam. Okay, it may be like at the exit you will get saturated steam. Okay, there may be different type of Rankine cycle. We will discuss it later on. So I think today I want to give you an introduction so that in coming week you will be able to, you can say, revise some basic concept, how to find out enthalpy in this region, how to find out enthalpy in this region, how to find out enthalpy in this region. Okay, because if you will find, you will check numerical related to this particular chapter, you can say steam turbine power plant in gate. So data will be given to you. Enthalpies at different saturated point will be given to you. Only you need to use that data. You need not to see any steam table like this. If you will find in, you will in a conventional paper, you need to use some kind of steam table. But in this gate questions, engineering service question, every data will be given to you. But how to apply, how to use that data, that is important. Okay, so there is some basic concept, basic information required for this particular topic, steam turbine power plant, for solving problems related to this. So that I am not discussing. What is that? Like properties of pure substancing. In detail, I am not discussing. But brief, I will discuss it later on when I will discuss that chapter in detail in next class. So that you can revise how to find out the properties of the pure substances in different region. Okay. So I think that is enough for today's class. Any question if you are having, you can ask. Rohit, next class, I think it will be on next Saturday. Next Saturday. Coming Saturday. Today is Sunday. So next coming Saturday is next class. Any question if you are having related to this particular topic, you can ask. Okay. So I'm ending this class so that you will able to revise. Any question if you are having, you can ask. Related to gas turbine power plant, we have discussed every single point which is required for gate examination, gate or engineering services. If you will find any syllabus, any problem related to gas turbine power plant, you will able to solve that. We have discussed in 2-3 lectures. Any point if you are having, you want to ask. Okay, so thank you very much. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Keep preparing.